My name is Unnur Helga Vífilsdóttir and I am going to discuss my micro-autobiography, as I choose to call it, and the methods I use to help me relive my memories. The title of my autobiography is Good Times, Bad Times. First of all, I would like to outline the subject of my autobiography and the type of memories I am discussing. The period I will be analyzing is a very sensitive one. It is about the first time I fell in love, my first relationship. I was only 15 years old, so this period is characterized by rebellion against my parents and authority. It followed, of course, a lot of bad decisions. I am going to try to analyze my own memories and make an attempt to see them from an academic standpoint. I would like to focus on my experience with Icelandic teenage culture in the years 2013 and 2014, and what it was like to be a small town girl from the western part of Iceland and experience the freedom and culture of Reykjavik. So what was this relationship like? First of all, it started off very innocently and had its normal sequence of events. We met with some friends and slowly but steadily we started to hang out. Quickly, it spiraled into total chaos. We were only together for about 15 months, but still it felt like a lifetime since it had a huge impact on my life and so many things took place in the relationship that altered my view on life. It was very verbally and mentally abusive relationship. I will not go into details in this introduction to my autobiography. In short, I was head over heels in love. Initially, our love affair was good, but after about 2 months, things started to get progressively worse every week. He had a very short fuse and was not afraid to speak his mind, no matter the consequences. As the relationship went on, my best friend at the time was almost begging me to stop seeing him. And at that point, he made me stop talking to her and a few other people I was used to hang out with. I was isolated socially and afraid to end the relationship. I did not have the courage to face his threats or stand up against him out of fear of being alone and what actions my boyfriend at the time would take. Eventually, he managed to almost destroy my relationship with my parents, but before it was too late, I finally got up the courage to end the whole thing. After we broke up, I actively repressed these memories. I did not want to recall any of our time together, so I engaged in the process of erasing all documents and memories that slightly reminded me of him. And I was, in fact, very successful in continuing with my life without even paying attention to the terror I had to endure. With this background in mind, I will be discussing my own experience with mental and verbal abuse from someone that you believe cares deeply about you. Now I will discuss the tactics I use to bring forth those repressed memories and dealing with them in a structured way. Number 1, 2, and 3 was music. I am a very musical person and have been all my life. As a teenager, music was my life and the way I survived the day. I came from a musical background since my mother was a music teacher. The music I listen to reflects how I feel from day to day. So naturally, it helped a lot to listen to the music I used to enjoy in that period of time. It brought back some very strong feelings, some good and others bad. The memories followed those feelings. My emotional life was all over the place during the time with my boyfriend, and it shows in the music. I have, without a doubt, tried to avoid these particular songs later in life in an attempt to repress the memories. Music was, in fact, the core of my friend group at the time. It was the embodiment of our life and something we bonded over. So music is very important when it comes to my teenage years. The next type of source I used to bring forth my memories was technology. In this day and age, it is very easy to find old conversations that are a very good primary source. This gives me a very clear image of communication between my boyfriend and myself, as well as my trusted friends at the time. We were in a sort of long-distance relationship for a while, so our communication was primarily through Facebook messages and phone calls during the weekdays. It was very interesting to look at these messages today and see them in a new light. It is also easier for me to look at this time critically and re-evaluate the way I look at my memories since I am no longer that same person. In fact, I have recently learned how to critically assess this part of my life. Even though I am looking at these messages through a critical perspective, it still puts me in the same emotional state as I was at the time. Facebook has also saved all of the pictures that I had deleted, so that was a very positive thing for this project. The pictures definitely helped to boost the memory and was just as important as all of the messages. The final thing I did was that I talked out loud. I found a way to talk to myself when I was thinking about this period in my life. I realized very quickly that it would be very hard for me to try to produce my memories from my mind and bring them into a narrative form. I found it very helpful to talk to someone out loud that I trusted and had no connection to the memories at all. I find that it's much easier to organize your own thoughts by being openly verbal. Everything can get kind of mixed up if you are stuck in your own mind. When I talk about my memories out loud to someone, they ask about details that I have overseen, and then you realize what you have to explain specifically. Important connections that I have slipped through my mind. When I try to do this on my own, I get kind of lost in the timeline, and I start to connect one memory with another, and then everything spirals out of control, and I get caught up in things that aren't important to the story. It helps me to reflect. Even though the person that I am speaking to doesn't necessarily add anything to the conversation, instead just listens. I would have liked to interview other people that were present in all the affair, for instance, my parents and my close friends, but I have unfortunately not had the opportunity to sit down with them and do that properly, since most of them live in a different part of Iceland. I have asked my parents if they would be willing to talk about this relationship to me and give their perspective on the sequence of events. It was very hard for me to take that step, since we have not talked about the events that unfolded during my relationship with this person since it happened. It is a very touchy subject in my family, which is why I was also shocked when they agreed to do this. I would not be able to reconnect with the boyfriend in question, since he tragically passed away in February of last year. This is a short summary of my experience and the methods in reliving and reviewing my own memories.